Can you even remind me to suck my stomach in? Dang.
No, because I think it's real.
Hey, Ruby.
Oh, hey.
What's going on?
What up?
What are we doing here today?
Today, we are recording another episode of Real Crafty. Real Crafty is when I show you how to do cool things with different stuff in our treats.
Try it again.
God, that's what it is. Okay. So today, I thought we'd do some coconut oil paws that I made earlier. And they got some parsley, blueberry, and beef liver in them.
Those might be the best looking things that Real Crafty has ever made.
But it's not about the look. It's about the taste. You feel me?
Are we going to taste it or?
Oh yeah, you can. I made one for you to taste.
Oh, did you? Well, I'm really excited about
that. Since you liked the popsicle so much. We are going to start with, I already chopped up some blueberries that I had earlier today.
Okay.
And I've got some parsley. Don't mind my cutting skills here.
Is there a particular type of parsley?
This is Italian parsley. So it's flat leaf, not curly.
Got it.
Both have the same benefits. They just taste and have a different texture.
Mm-hmm.
The dogs don't care, but I like using parsley because they're really great for freshening up their breath.
What else are the health benefits of parsley?
Well, just like any herbs, I don't know. The greens are really good for vitamin C, just like any cruciferous vegetable.
Wow.
You know what that means, Sam?
I do. So
he's lucky that he's behind the camera.
I want to let everyone know. I don't want to waste wasting their precious time talking.
We're gonna put some parsley up in there.
Lovely.
I got these little paw molds from Amazon. I think they were like $7.
Mm-hmm.
We got this mold plus these little bone molds, which are so cute.
Now, should they also fall in between the?
You know, it's
I'm
fine
just
if
asking.
They do.
Yeah.
If you want to clean it up,
you can.
You can totally do that. Then we're gonna throw some blueberries in there.
Mm-hmm.
We like blueberries because of the antioxidants.
Yep.
And if your dog is anything like mine, they're not interested in fruit at all.
Whoops. Mm-hmm.
Probably a question we're gonna get after this is whether dogs need fruits and vegetables. And the answer is, we know that there's no dietary requirement for them. So do they need them? No. Can they be beneficial? Probably. Their nutritional properties like vitamin C, antioxidants, all the stuff you find in fruits and vegetables and the reasons we consume them, that doesn't change for dogs. They hopefully can absorb the nutrition in the same way that we can, but studies are still going to figure that out.
Can't they eat? Yeah.
They can't eat grapes, the seeds or core of an apple or an avocado. But outside of that, you know, all of like the watery fruits, watermelon, cantaloupe, the melons.
Yeah.
Those are awesome. Some dogs like bananas. They like apples, carrots and green beans and broccoli. My dog does not. He like won't touch them.
He's just a meat guy.
So that's why I do this.
Sneak a little blueberry in.
Yeah. In addition to these, kind of to entice him a little bit, I'm going to throw some beef liver up in there.
Oh, love that.
These little pieces right here. Just break them up. You can use anything to hold this together, right? You could really put water in here if you wanted to. Bone broth, orange juice, but you probably don't want to do that. Instead, I'm using coconut oil today. This is extra virgin coconut oil. And all that means that it's not refined because you want to stay away from anything that's refined. That means it's cooked. Boiled, probably lost a lot of its nutritional properties, like anything that's heated.
Yep.
So I chose coconut oil because they have a lot of antibacterial and antifungal properties. A lot of people apply coconut oil to like itchy, dry skin.
Yeah, people use it on their faces, they're like as lotion.
On their teeth? Mm-hmm. I know, Alicia brushes her teeth with coconut oil.
It's called oil pulling.
Oil pulling?
Yeah.
Or pooling?
No one knows.
That's gotten into the black hole of the English language.
So I got my coconut oil right here. And let's see if I can pour this into the mold.
Yep, very nice. Yes. Does it expand a little bit? You're only pouring just a little bit in, but those seem pretty full, the done ones.
Actually, the reason I'm not filling them up all the way is because I wasn't sure if this little thing would have enough. When you're using these silicone molds, you'll find that they're super easy to get stuff out of, but when you're transferring them from here to the freezer, if they're super full, you're gonna drop it.
You seem like you're speaking from experience.
So that's why I've got this cutting board right under here, and you can use something that's firm, but maybe just more similar in size. So you just pick it up like this and stick it in the freezer.
Boom. Like that.
Just like that. Did
Boom.
You get that?
Yep. Love that.
One more time.
Boom.
You can use cardboard. I use the top of a Tupperware.
Tupperware.
So this is the final product.
Look at this.
Are you ready for a taste, Sam?
Yes.
It's a breath freshener.
Okay, well,
coconut
I need that
oil,
for sure. Beef
blueberry,
liver.
And parsley. Go on, take a bite.
That's really good.
Except the liver?
Excuse me. I'm not kidding. This is actually quite good.
The silicone molds are awesome because they just pop right out.
And you can you do this in a regular ice tray or?
Yeah, sure you can. But I do recommend using the silicone so that they don't break apart.
Let's have Chini try this. He wants a fresh one. He likes a fresh one.
He's like, why would I eat that?
Yeah.
When I got this?
Why would I chew when I can actually just lick? You want to let people know if they want to put in submissions?
Please show me your best paws coconut molds. They don't have to be paws. You can do whatever you want.
Turk's trying it. It's good. Eat the whole thing. He's very wimply trying it.
That's how he
how
eats.
Is it?
He has a small mouth.
Yeah. That's what.
It's gum.
I know.
That's good,
you
right?
You like it. We've loved your crafty submissions so far. Make sure you keep sending them in. Thanks for all your videos. #RealCrafty.
What?